Next topic, it is diarrhea. So diarrhea, it is already, like, you all know what is diarrhea. So diarrhea, it is an increase in the frequency of the bowel movements. Okay, it is increase in the frequency of the bowel movements or decrease in the form of stool. Okay, so it is diarrhea, it is usually like increase in the frequency of the bowel movement or decrease in the form of stool. So this diarrhea usually causes dehydration. Okay, so diarrhea, it is an increase in the frequency of the stool. Okay, so diarrhea, it is usually increase in the frequency of the stool. Oh, sorry. Diarrhea is usually increase in the frequency of the bowel movement or decrease in the form of stool. Okay, decrease in the form of stool. So this diarrhea usually causes dehydration. Okay, this diarrhea usually causes dehydration. So in this diarrhea, children are more likely to be affected compared to adults. And children also more likely to die more than adults because of dehydration. Okay, because of dehydration. So diarrhea, it is not a disease, it is usually a symptom. Okay, diarrhea is not a disease, but it is usually a symptom of several diseases. Okay, several GI disorders. Okay, so it is diarrhea, it is not a disease, but it is usually a symptom, and this is usually a symptom of various diseases. So it is mainly diarrhea, it is usually passage of frequently liquid stools. Okay, so it's passage of frequently liquid stools. What is this diarrhea? So diarrhea, it is usually an increase in the frequency of bowel movement or decrease in the form of stool. This causes dehydration. So children are more affected by this diarrhea compared to adults, and they also die more compared to adults due to dehydration. And this diarrhea, it is not a disease, but it is usually a symptom of several diseases. So diarrhea, it is usually passage of liquid stools. Okay, passage of liquid stool, that is usually there. So next is, and this usually there may be different types, like acute diarrhea and chronic diarrhea. So this acute diarrhea will be last for 1 or 2 days. Okay, it will be present in 1 or 2 days, and it will be like it will go by itself. Okay, so acute diarrhea and chronic diarrhea. So there are usually different types, like acute diarrhea and chronic diarrhea. So acute diarrhea will be present for 1 or 2 days, and it will go by itself. Chronic diarrhea, which will be like it will be present for a longer period. Okay, it will be present with longer period. So this usually will be present for 4 weeks. Okay, it usually will be present for 4 weeks, and this will be present due to some chronic disease. Okay, it will be present for some due to some chronic disease. So diarrhea, it is usually frequent, increase in the frequency of the bowel movements. Okay, diarrhea is usually increase in the frequency of the bowel movements, or there is decrease in the stool, and it causes dehydration. And this diarrhea, it is usually a disease, it is not a disease, but it is usually a symptom of various diseases. And this is passage of liquid stool, and is of two types, like acute diarrhea and chronic diarrhea will be there. So acute diarrhea, it usually occurs suddenly, and it will be present for 1 or 2 days, and it goes by itself. Chronic diarrhea will be present for a longer duration, and it will be present due to the associated with any other chronic disease. Other than that, the other diarrheal diseases, other types of diarrheal diseases, like non-inflammatory and inflammatory. So non-inflammatory, it might be due to intestinal infections. Okay, so non-inflammatory may be due to intestinal infections such as cholera and giardia. Okay, so this in non-intestinal may be due to intestinal infections such as cholera and giardia, where there is due to this there is alteration in the intestinal absorption of fluids. Okay, where there is alteration in the intestinal absorption of fluids. So that is usually there. So that is mainly, so this type of diarrhea, so that is non-inflammatory diarrhea may usually leads to, they'll be having large volume of watery diarrhea. Okay, they'll be having large amount of watery diarrhea, which is associated with cramp, blotting, with mild or no fever. Okay, with mild or no fever. So it is non-inflammatory, that would be due to intestinal infections. Okay, it might be due to intestinal infections such as giardia or cholera. So this is usually where they'll be having watery diarrhea, abdominal blotting will be there, fever will be there, or there might be no fever. So that is usually about this intestinal or non-inflammatory diarrhea. In case of this inflammatory diarrhea, it is also known as dysentery. Okay, it is also known as dysentery. So where they'll be characterized by bloody diarrhea. Okay, so where they'll be characterized with bloody diarrhea. So this is caused by microbes such as Shigella and E. coli. Okay, it is mainly caused by microbes such as Shigella and E. coli that usually invades the colon and triggers this. Okay, that invades the colon and triggers this. So it is mainly the types of this acute diarrhea will be occurring suddenly, or it will last for 1 or 2 days and then it goes. Chronic diarrhea, it usually occurs like due to some other chronic diseases. It will be present for at least four weeks. And then in inflammatory and non-inflammatory, it is due to intestinal parasites such as cholera and giardia, which usually causes, like, there will be alteration in the fluid absorption. Okay, there will be alteration in the fluid absorption. And inflammatory will be due to, it is usually caused by Shigella and E. coli. It might be due to, it is also known as dysentery, where there will be bloody diarrhea. It usually what it does is that this microbes usually invades the colon and triggers the inflammation. So that is usually about this types, that is acute, chronic, non-inflammatory and inflammatory. So a non-inflammatory is intestinal parasites, and inflammatory, it is also known as dysentery, where there will be bloody diarrhea. It is mainly caused due to E. coli and Shigella, which invades the colon and causes the infection. So this is causes of diarrhea. So the causes of diarrhea, there are different causes of diarrhea, like bacterial cause, viral cause, parasitic cause, or due to some food allergy. So mainly we'll see one by one what are the causes of this diarrhea. So in case of this bacterial infection, so common bacteria which causes the infection or causes diarrhea, it might be like Campylobacter, Vibrio fishes, Salmonella, Shigella, E. coli, Staphylococcus, Clostridium. So there is common bacteria that usually causes this is Campylobacter, Vibrio, Salmonella, Staphylococcus, Shigella, E. coli and Clostridium. And next is viral infections. The viral infection which is usually responsible for causing this diarrhea includes rotavirus, norovirus, parvovirus, adenovirus, cytomegalovirus or viral hepatitis. So the viral infection that is usually causes this diarrhea, it is a common virus that causes diarrhea. It is rotavirus, norovirus, parvovirus, adenovirus, cytomegalovirus, hepatitis, viral hepatitis viruses. So this is parasites. Parasites that usually causes this diarrhea include Giardia, Lamblia, Cryptosporidium, Entamoeba, Histolica. Okay, so that is the parasites which usually causes this diarrhea. It includes like Giardia, Lamblia, Cryptosporidium, and Entamoeba, Histolica. So that is usually about this causes parasitic infections. So next is due to some intestinal diseases. Okay, that is due to some intestinal diseases such as irritable bowel syndrome. Okay, due to intestinal diseases such as irritable bowel syndrome. Then it might be due to some food intolerances. Okay, so sensitivity to certain foods. Okay, food intolerance or sensitivity to certain food. So that is lactose. Okay, so that is lactose with that is. Continue with the topic diarrhea. So in the previous class we had dealt with like definition, types of diarrheal diseases, causes of diarrheal diseases. So there are different causes of diarrheal diseases like bacterial causes, viral infections, parasitic infections, intestinal diseases, or food intolerance or sensitivities. So that is we were dealing with this causes of diarrhea. So in that mainly it usually includes is that bacterial infection. So some of the common bacterial infection that usually causes this is like Vibrio cholerae, Vibrio species, or it might be due to Campylobacter, Salmonella, Shigella, E. coli. So all these are the bacteria which usually causes this diarrheal. So next is viral infection. So there are viruses which usually causes this diarrhea. It might be like rotavirus, norovirus, parvovirus, adenovirus. So these are usually the different virus which is usually causes this diseases. Okay, this is usually the different viruses which usually causes this disease. And next is parasitic. Parasitic, it might be like Giardia, Lamblia and Clostridium. So it is usually Cryptosporidium. Okay, so it is Giardia, Lamblia or Cryptosporidium. So these are usually the parasites that usually causes this infection. And next it might be due to intestinal disorders such as irritable bowel syndrome. Okay, or the person might be certain, he might be sensitive to certain food. Okay, he might be sensitive to certain food like lactose. Okay, like lactose which is present in the sugar. Okay, lactose which is present in the sugar. So they might be like sensitive to certain food which might lead to this diarrhea. And next is usually like due to reaction due to certain medicines. Okay, reaction due to certain medicines such as like antibiotics, cancer drugs. Okay, antibiotics, cancer drugs. This usually causes this diarrhea. So these are usually the causes of diarrhea. So next is risk factors. There are certain risk factors which involves like they might be risk in developing this diarrhea. So it might be due to food poisoning. So diarrhea might be like they might be developing when they are having food poisoning or eating food which might like irritate digestive system. Okay, so eating food that might irritate the digestive food. So that is food poisoning or eating food that might irritate the digestive system. Or it might be due to allergy to certain food. Okay, certain people will be having allergic to certain food like brinjal, egg, shellfish. So if they are allergic to certain food, so if such type of food if they have or such type of food if they have, so they might develop this diarrhea. Okay, so that is usually there. And next, in case of radiation therapy, okay, it might be due to radiation therapy or if they are having malabsorption. Okay, if they are having malabsorption, so that time also they develop this diarrhea. And next is in case of hyperthyroidism. Okay, so diarrhea will be seen in case of hyperthyroidism or alcohol abuse. Okay, if he is continuously having alcohol abuse, okay, that time usually they develop this diarrhea. or in case of diabetes. So these are usually the risk factors that usually seen that they might develop this diarrhea. So that is usually it includes is mainly like they might be risk factors such as they might be include like food poisoning, eating food that might irritate digestive system, or in case of allergic to food, allergic to certain food, radiation therapy, malabsorption, diabetes, hyperthyroidism, or in case of alcohol abuse. Okay, so these are usually the risk factors which is involved in this diarrhea. So next is symptoms. Symptoms is usually seen that there will be watery stools, passage of watery stools. Along with that, they will be having abdominal cramp, abdominal pain, nausea. So that is usually about this thing. Other than that, you can see that they will be having loss of appetite, vomiting will be there, fever will be seen, dehydration. So that is mainly symptoms is that they will be having frequent passage of watery stool or loose stools. And then abdominal pain will be there, abdominal cramps will be there, nausea, vomiting will be there, loss of appetite, dehydration, and also they will be having pricking sensation. Okay, they will be having pricking sensation. So these are usually the symptoms that is usually associated with diarrhea. Okay, these are symptoms which is associated with diarrhea. So next is diagnostic evaluation. So what is this diagnostic evaluation? So mainly we go with medical history and physical examination. Okay, mainly we go with medical history and physical examination, where we will be collecting like whether they had some medications, or whether they are taking some medications, or whether they are undergoing chemotherapy and radiation therapy, or whether they are allergic to certain foods. So what all these things will be collecting, history as well as physical examination will be done. And then we'll go with stool examination. Okay, we go with stool examination. So in the stool examination, stool culture will be done, like bacterial culture will be there. This stool culture is mainly done to know the exact bacteria which is responsible for this diarrhea. So stool culture is done mainly to know the exact bacteria which is causing this diarrhea. Next, gram stain will be done. Okay, so next is gram stain will be done. So this usually differentiates gram positive bacteria and gram negative bacteria. Okay, so this usually differentiates gram positive as well as gram negative bacteria, so that we can know which type of infection has occurred to that person. Okay, so that we can know which type of infection has occurred to that person. So that is usually there. Next is over positive parasite testing. So next with we go this over positive parasite testing is done. So this is usually stool sample will be sent, and this usually will be checking the presence of which type of parasites. Okay, to know the exact type of parasites, or if there is any X, okay, in the stools that is causing the infection. So that is usually seen. And next is, so this is about the stool test. So stool test we go with like culture will be done to know the exact organism that is causing the diarrhea. And next is gram stain test will be done, the way to differentiate like between gram positive and gram negative. So when this is done, so we can know exactly what type of infection is occurred. And then over positive parasite test is done, then this stool sample is sent, where we will be checking the presence of parasites or eggs. So this is about the stool test. So next is blood test. Blood test also we go with culture. So culture here also, the exact reason for this infection will be knowing about the exact organism that is causing the infection will be known in this blood test. So that is usually done. And then we go with sigmoidoscopy and colonoscopy. Okay, sigmoidoscopy and colonoscopy. So this is done mainly to know if the person is having any intestinal disorders. Okay, this is mainly done to know whether the person is having any intestinal disorders, and this is mainly done in order to know the exact cause for this chronic diarrhea. Okay, to know the exact cause for this chronic diarrhea. So this is what the diagnostic test that is usually done. So they go with medical history and physical examination, stool examination, blood examination, and then sigmoidoscopy and colonoscopy. So this is about this diagnostic evaluation that is usually done. So next is management. So in case of this management, it mainly depends like antibiotics will be given, over-counter diarrheal drugs will be given, as well as oral rehydration therapy will be given. So management mainly we go with like antibiotics will be given, oral rehydration therapy will be given, as well as over-the-counter diarrheal drugs will be given. Okay, over-the-counter diarrheal drugs will be given. So in this over-the-counter diarrheal drugs, we go with giving them loperamide. Okay, we go with giving them loperamide and bismuth salicylate. Okay, so that is the over-counter diarrheal drugs that we give it is that loperamide will be given or bismuth subsalicylate will be given. So that is mainly used in adults to stop diarrhea. Then in most of the cases, like we have to replace the lost fluid and electrolytes, okay, because it leads to dehydration. So we have to replace the lost fluid and electrolytes. So therefore, they have to ask the person to drink at least 6 to 8 ounce glass of fluids per day. Okay, 6 to 8 ounce glass of fluids per day. So that is usually done. And then they can have this fruit juices can be given. Okay, we can ask them to drink fruit juices also. So that is usually done. Then we can ask them to drink like chicken broth can also be done without fat. Okay, without using the fat. Then tea with honey. Okay, tea with honey can be done. Sports drink can be drink. Okay, sports drink. So that is they have to drink fluids frequently. Okay, they have to drink fluids frequently. That is fluid and electrolyte replacements have to be done. So they can drink this fluids regularly, frequently. Like 6 to 8 ounce glasses of fluid should be taken. Like they can go with fruit juices. Chicken broth can be used, or they can use this what is that? Tea with honey, or any sports drinks can also be done. So it is usually done. Then until diarrhea is not stopping. Okay, until diarrhea is present, caffeine products should be avoided. Okay, caffeine products should be avoided, and also food which is high in fiber. Okay, food which is high in fiber can be taken, so that usually lessens the symptoms. Okay, food which is high in fiber can be taken because it will reduce the symptoms. Okay, it will reduce the symptoms. So caffeine products should be completely avoided, and like this food, like high in fiber food should be taken. So that is usually about this thing. And then as symptoms improves, okay, as symptoms improves, blunt food can be given. Okay, as food, symptoms improve, blunt food can be given. So that is usually about this management. So management, we go with giving them antibiotics. Okay, different antibiotics will be like ampicillin, cipromycin, ciprofloxacin. So antibiotics is given mainly to reduce the bacterial infection. And then over-the-counter drugs is given like loperamide and Bismuth subsalicylate will be given. Then we have to replace the fluid and electrolytes. So in order to replace the fluid and electrolytes, we have to ask them to drink much of fluids. And then until and unless diarrhea stops, caffeine products should be avoided. And high fiber diet can be taken. Then if symptoms reduces, blunt diet can be given. Okay, blunt diet can be given to the patient. So this is about this diarrhea. So diarrhea is nothing but, it is not a disease but it is a symptom of many other diseases. So where there will be passage of loose watery stools. Okay, this is usually about this diarrhea.